Hey everyone, at my other job again, because today is November 4th, so day before bonfire night, but I'm out on a display which I'm going to be careful about where I put the camera, because it's a primary school. Even though the school's closed now, there's still kids around, so I've got to be careful. But yeah, so as you can see, some lovely fireworks set up. Got some new things this year, including a new system. One of the things that someone's asked me in the past is, how does it work? Well, this is a module, and you can see it's lots of plugs on it and lots of wires. The wires go to basically like an electronic match, and that match is then directly put into the firework. Today we're using four of these. You may notice the odd one's got nothing in it. There is a reason behind that. Because of the depth that we have on this site, as well as the width and stuff on this site, we decided it was best to put stuff in various different places. But yeah, there's lots of fireworks. There's another module just there. As I say, it's a brand new system to me. I've had some brief instruction on this one. But to be honest, when you know one system, you know them all. But yeah, so this is the first display of the season for me. Lots and lots of juicy fireworks. We mainly use brands. The two brands that we mainly use is Jubilee, who are known for doing the Alton Towers displays, and Jonathan's, which like that is a Jonathan's item there, as well as this thing over here. This thing's wrapped up to keep it dry. Oh no, sorry, that's a Jubilee. I'm corrected. And this is 50mm shells. Nice big Big-badda-boom. It's 50mm shells in one thing, ready to go. You just plonk it in the ground, put your detonate lead in, which if I just move this ever so carefully, you can see just about there. That's where it goes in. It's basically like a match head. There you go. You just about see it. It's probably not in focus though. It's just basically like a match head and lights it. So yeah, so bit better angle of the site just here, and I should be following at some point is the footage of it all going boom. You'll probably hear me randomly talking over it while it's going boom, because most likely we'll be firing this as it's a system that I kind of semi know. And I have to speak out loud just to try and make it clear exactly what I'm doing when I'm going with a new sequence. The box is over the other side of the field at the moment. I've got to be careful about turning the camera. Like I say, school is closed now, but we just need to be careful because it's a primary school. It could be a bit iffy about it. But oh, okay, I was saying about how it works. So over there you've got the module. And then down here we've got these white leads. They're better than some systems. Some systems have black leads. That's never clever. And basically comes along to a parallel plug, which is on the end here, which at the moment I've taped, A, to keep them dry in case it rains. Oh, serial plug, sorry. Like a printer one. Printer was parallel, not serial. Can't think. One of the two. Comes to these, terminates in these. We've labelled them. Got like my own labelling code, so I know exactly what's what. And that goes into our yellow box of magic of switches, which we use to set everything off. So yeah, I'll show you some more in a bit. But I need to eat. I've been going since 9:15 this morning, and so far all I've had is a croissant. How middle class does that sound? Here's a croissant and a chocolate bar. Oh, by the way, new glasses! Yeah!
Are we ready? We can't hear you. Are we ready? Here we go then. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
ahead of time. Okay. Hey everyone, excuse the hood, it's bloody cold today, but today's my second and last display of the season. It's a short season for me this year because Bonfire Night fell on a Saturday and everyone wanted their displays today and yesterday. So I've just got on site, all my equipment and stuff and pyro has been dropped off. Also on this site tonight we have a bonfire, which is always good. I've got to put some stuff in that to get it started. But yeah, I realised yesterday, not showing you the system that we use, I was a bit rushed because we was getting some stuff together and sorted. So I thought first thing today, before I got anything set up, I'll give you another show of how the system works. So if I just get this open and get them out of the way. Right, this is a new system for us, different to our old ones. Comes in a nice yellow waterproof tough box thing, it's great. Now, we have what we know as sats or modules, which is what we plug the fireworks into. And these look like, I'll grab one, this. That's a module, and you can see they're numbered on the front. What they have is like basically a parallel or serial, I can't remember which it is now, I think it's parallel printer cable connector. If it focuses, there we go. And we just get long leads, which are over there, and plug them into this. Now, number one is your first one, and it goes all the way around to number 10. Now, what's weird with this is we can have, how many is it now? 2, 4, 5 of these modules plugged into it, as a master module kind of thing. But all of them are number 1 to 10. So what I do is, right on the back, what they're going to be. So number 4, I'd plug in slot number 4 here. But yeah, so cool thing about this system is if you wanted to, and if you needed to for your show design, you can daisy chain them. So you can put another one in the end there and have two of these. And basically both things are in number 1. When you hit switch for number 1, both things will go off together. It's absolutely awesome. But the way this also works, you have your safety key, you turn that and it instantly comes live. Now, I don't know if you can quite see, it tells you how much voltage your system's reporting to you as well. And then when you're ready to fire, you have all your cables connected and you flick this switch to make that module active. And then all you need to do when you need to fire something is flick a switch. This is number 1, this is number 10. And you go boom, 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 boom. It's that simple. It's cracking system. It's new for us. We had these old kind of big briefcase things that had buttons that also had switches and various things. It's powered, and this is all we need to set up fireworks. Some industrial strength 9-volt batteries. Except for they're not 9-volt, I don't think. I think they're higher than 9-volt, to be honest. But that's what we use. Oh, they are 9-volt. But it uses a step-up system inside to get you up to 24 from the 3 9-volt batteries. I think it's various capacitors and things like that. It's cracking. And these bits here is allows you to plug in a booster battery. So if you've got a really long run of these, you might not, and multiple things going off together, should I say, there may not be quite enough juice to get all the way along. So what you can do is you can plug in an extra battery using banana plug, and that allows you to step up the voltage and amperage that comes out of this. What it does, it will set off what we call an electric match. I'm just trying to see if I've got one close to hand. Somewhere. I'm just trying to find one now. Give me a second. Right, this is an electric match, or what we call sometimes DETS. Basically, if I pull this sheathing back, it's difficult to do one-handed, and when it's cold, it's a bit stuck. So I don't know if you're just about seeing there, there's like a match head inside. And what it does, we plug the leads, which you got positive and negative, on that, which it's not going to focus on. Come on, focus. 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 Yeah, it's not going to focus on it today. It's going to be a pain. You plug that into this, and then when you apply the voltage, this little cap blasts, gives you a nice quick shot of quite intense hot flame,
which will then light the gunpowder on the fuse. I'll show you some stuff once I set it up so you can see how this attaches to the firework. But yeah, I'm solo in this job today. It's going to be a long day, a long, tiring day. But when the light catches up, it's going to be fun. One of the things we have is unique to our company is the way we design the shops. We have this, which I can't show you for too long, which is our firing order. Now, over the years, we've all learnt our boss's patterns and our show designer's patterns that he puts on these sheets to tell us how to set everything up and exactly how they intend the show to look. So I'll be following this and setting everything up to get ready to go. It's now currently about 11:15, half 11. I think they're firing at 7 o'clock-ish, around about 7, half 6, 7. I'm on my own, so I better get my act together and get going, because I've got all that lot set up over there and some other bits and pieces here as well. This is for making the bonfire go boom, along with this bit as well. This is the cool thing. This is a thing we make. It's made exclusively by us. You can see there, it's got one of those electronic matches dets attached. Oh no, in fact, not attached. It's just here, the electronic det. We'll put it in the end there, which is, this is the tube that contains basically strings of gunpowder. It's probably not in focus yet again. We'll stick this in the middle of the bonfire. And then when we hit the button, or flip the switch in this case, this will create a lot of heat in the middle of the fire and get it burning. So that thing will get up and burning in hardly any time at all. So yeah, I better get going. Right, okay, this is a SIB, or single ignition barrage. It's one called, name of it is Superstars, it has 200 shots. Now when you open one of these, you'll find, some companies do this, a lot of them are doing it now, you'll have a main fuse. And the main fuse is, you'll have this, which is an E-port, and then you have this, which is your Soburn safety fuse. So what you need to do is, because they always tape them down, which is really annoying, let's cut the tape to get them loose. Let's put it on the other side as well. There we go. So there you go. You get your two fuses there, your slow burn, which is when you're hand firing a show, and your E-port. Now what you need to do, you pull the little plug out the E-port, which it does to keep it protected and dry, and that little bit of plastic, you go and put in your bin. And then you look inside to make sure you can see gunpowder. If you can see gunpowder, you're all good. Then you get your E-match, or DET, then literally stick it in the end like that. Now once it's in the end, you wrap it round twice. So once, and then wrap it round the other way. This is really difficult to do one-handed. Really is. I need to get some way of being able to film hands-free. And that's it. That is ready to go. You then go and put it on the site, stick it in the ground, you're all good. Right, bit of an update. Everything's got dets in. You see stuff's all over. That's the kind of mangled mess of cables we get out the modules. It can get messy. But yeah, say right now, all I'm doing is going through plugging in. I'm at number 18, which says 8 on here. On number 18 of 25 to get fused in. Once all that's done, then it's staking and everything, securing it. Then after that's done, it's then going sorting out the fire start for them. It's now, let's have a look, what time is it now? It is now, just gone 2:05. A few hours left. I should be on target. I'm just tired. It's cold, but it's cloudy, but dry. That's the main thing. Been a bit, so I've got to go over there to that to go and sort it out and get it ready to be. Well, again, there was an abrupt finish to the last video. That's because I ran out of battery, but it's been on charge. Thank you to my lovely battery pack. But yes, I'm set up. Everything's staked and secure, and it's all wired in and all been tested once, but I'm gonna go and test it again just because I've been walking through this site like I am now. See, stepping. And these things you don't want to step on. yeah, it's done there. And then also over here, I'll walk over there, my fire start is ready. Go over to it. Oh god, it's cold today. Anyway, this is our fire start. I've got some pots and a random cake, and then there's my module hidden there. And then in there we got a special device that we make that I showed you earlier that gets the fire going. And then some rubbish paper and card and stuff like that. So yeah, I am ready. And where's my piece of paper? My piece of paper says that, hang on, god, my lips are bright red. It's chafage from the wind. I look, I'm wearing lipstick. Fire display at 7:15 and bonfire lighting is 6:45. Time now is, I need to stop licking my lips because this is going to make it worse. Time now is, there we go, 20 past four. It's relaxing time now. Time to relax and have a think. Now look at this, it's dry. It's dry.
Hey guys, hope you enjoyed that one. That was an interesting display. I've just realised how red my lips are because of the cold. Yeah, and I also don't know how much you can see because, well, I've tried to get a light, but yeah. Now, after all that, it's the bit of the job that no pyro enjoys doing. That is the cleanup. I mean, I've got most of the pyro off the site, the dead pyro that is. Luckily, because there's a bonfire here, which is over there now, over there somewhere. Anyway, we can burn a lot of it, which is nice.
I just realised my beard has probably been singeing slightly by putting stuff on there. But if I get my light over there and show you, there's still a lot of mess to clean up. And yeah, it's the bit no one likes. At least with all the fireworks going off in the area, I get an enjoyable soundtrack to listen to of explosions. But yeah, hope you enjoyed this video. Oh, I've got something in the background then, but I moved. That's clever. Hope you enjoyed these videos. If you did, thumbs up. If you didn't, oh well. Subscribe for more random vlogs and stuff like that. And until next time, I'll see you around. Bye.